I move to strike the last
word. Gentleman from New Hampshire is recognized for 5 minutes.
I thank the chairman for recognizing me, and I have great respect for my colleague from California and all the hard work that he's done now for generations, practically, on this issue. I would point out that from the late 70s through all of the 80s, special education was funded at 1%, 2%, 3%, 4%. And it wasn't until 1995, 1996, 1997, actually 96, 97, 98, 99, into the 2000s that funding for special education began to increase significantly under the Republican-controlled Congress. President Clinton's own education secretary said on a number of different occasions that full funding of special education had to take a second place to the new programs that the administration was offering at the time, which was school construction, school improvement, and these other programs that my friend, the maker of the amendment, is proposing to reduce in order to fund special education. I have felt for many years that IDEA funding should be the top priority for education funding in the Congress, and I'm pleased that we have this amendment that will restore funding to the same level that it was in fiscal year 2010. And I would certainly like to have it higher than that, but under the circumstances, I believe that this is a good and justifiable improvement. And it's especially important, and it's different from SIP and teacher quality grants, because we make the rules when it comes to special education here at the federal level. And the school districts put out their individual service plans for students, which they have to pay for. So without this amendment and with a cut in funding for special education, it is a direct dollar-for-dollar cost shift to every school district in America. So this is an amendment that is good, it should be bipartisan, and we should all support its passage so that we can get special education funding back to FY10 levels. And I yield back the balance of my time.
Gentleman yields back his time.